New year, same flower. Hopefully I'll upload this on the Yo! Hey guys, what's up? Happy New Year! It's your favorite flower coming to you live, not from the 615, but from the 954. Yes, I am home.
You know what today is? I'm coming to you with what? I feel like Dora right now. Do you see the flower? Click on the flower. You already know what it is, what it do. Hi guys, how goes things? I hope everyone enjoyed their holidays, and I want to say thank you everybody for the birthday wishes. I really do appreciate it. Shout out to all my Capricorns out there. I peeped that had a lot of Capricorn followers, and I was like, oh yeah, see, they know what's up. That's why we here. We have lots to discuss in today's video, so let's get this show on the road. Let's get this.
She has super
borrowing
changes. Honestly, I'm gonna keep it real. Sometimes I feel some type of way because I don't have a lot of changes. Like, if anything, budding is always happening. You know, I'm always saying that in every video. Budding is inevitable. So if I have nothing else to say, I can always rely on budding because I think that that's a constant thing that's always happening. But other than budding, not really much that's been changing. Lane? I didn't even talk about length in the last video, but I definitely asked you guys. I was like, I think I'm keeping some length. Ooh. Like, I now I don't even have to put my head a certain type of way. I can just leave it regularly and my hair naturally touches my shoulders. On the right side, it's not touching my shoulders yet. As you can see, I still got like a little way to go. A little inch. You feel me? Left side. I'm impressed with the left side, and I'm a righty, so. So yes, length, budding, and growth. Those are the three things that really caught my eye this month. That's what I really paid attention to. Not many other changes have been happening. Before I go into the 360 and then start my routine, I wanted to tell you guys what's going to be happening this month specifically that's been different from all the other 4 months. I don't know what I was thinking. I guess I thought that I was going to be back in Nashville by now for my fifth month update, but I'm not. And I left my locking gel at Nashville. Now, although I do have another locking gel here, I don't want to switch up, especially when my hair has been responding so positively to the routine that's already been set. I don't want to go switching it, you know, and then like switch it back. I don't know how it's gonna react. I don't want to know how it's gonna react. I'm not curious to use another gel. I also don't want to buy a whole new container of locking gel because I've got a pretty good amount back at Nashville. About 3/4 of it is still there. So with that being said, the only thing that's going to be different this update is that I'm not going to be using a gel, period. I'm just going to be retwisting with water. I'm still going to be washing my hair with the African black soap. And also, because I'm not in my dorm, I do not have a hair dryer to go up under. So I'm going to be air drying. While I'm air drying, I'm going to be talking to you guys about things regarding my YouTube channel and just the lock community in general. We're going to have like a little face-to-face conversation. Let's get down to this 360, shall we? I have no space for a 360 right now. I'm sorry, hold up. Alright, so this is the front.
Lots of growth. Yes, yes.
Forgive me, I have no space right here for a 360 the way I set this up. Side note, I remember way back when I was really concerned about these little four locks back here in the kitchen. Hold up.
these. It's crazy because I was really concerned about those four in the back. They were on my kitchen. I thought that they weren't gonna lock properly. I thought I was gonna have problems with unraveling when I retwisted them in the back because they were so small. I see how my hair has transformed and I see it growing just by looking at the four little ones in the back. Like, it's crazy. Like, this is crazy to me. Oh my god. I don't think anybody understands, yo. Having locks or just wearing your natural hair out, period. It's just so empowering to know that you're killing the game with your hair, you know? Like, you didn't go buy this. This is yours. okay, yeah. So I'm about to go wash my hair and retwist it. I will see you guys when I'm done. Hi, hi. So retwisting definitely took longer than I thought it would. Longer to the point where I don't think I'm going to show the after results of my completely dried hair just because it's already 11 something where I'm at. Someone comment on the last video, she was like, girl, you forever missing the eighth. I was like, I know, but come on now, eighth for effort. When I say I think I have a small case of OCD, I'm not kidding. Sorry, you know, little droplets of water may drip. So this whole retwisting with water thing, I'm not gonna lie. Going into this, I was like, oh yes, I am doing the all natural way, man, bump lock gel. I might just do this. I was wrong. I feel like retwisting with water is just a little bit more sloppy than retwisting with gel. And that's just my opinion, you know? I'm not saying it's right or wrong. I'm just saying that's how I felt retwisting my locks right now with water for the first time. I don't know. It's just making the comparison. Maybe it's because I've been locking with gel for 4 months and now the fifth month I'm using water and I'm not used to it. But like, No. I felt like it took a lot for me to personally feel like it was okay. Like, I didn't even get past like the third row in the back and I'm already like, oh no, okay, I have to do all this over because I feel like it's slipping out. I feel like, you know, I saw a little fuzziness. Everything, like I've said before, like in my mind, like everything gotta go accordingly. You feel me? Notification. I don't care if you're going live on Instagram. Oh no, but like seriously, that is why my retwist took so long, because I'm over here trying to make sure it's coming out nicely. I feel like this retwist is not gonna be my favorite, but then again, I could be wrong, but I guess we'll see. To be honest, the only reason I'm not gonna show you the aftermath is because this is what I want to talk about anyway, so I guess this is just gonna lead up into that. It's 2017. Definitely want to add some stuff on here. Definitely want to maybe pull back on some things. I wanted to get your opinion on how you guys felt seeing my hair before and after my wash and retwist routine. I'm asking because school starts next week. I thought I was busy last semester, but it's only gonna get worse. Not saying that it's a bad thing, you know, I'm just really getting involved with my major and I'm diving in. So I know it would be easier for me personally on the editing and recording aspect of the channel. If you do appreciate seeing the before and after, then I will definitely find some middle ground so that we can all be happy. Bottom line is, I'm thinking about doing my routine and then coming on here afterwards and then giving it to you guys straight. So that's with that. So I'll be making a video before the 6 month update, all the hairstyles that I've been doing thus far. So that should be really fun. I wanted to talk about the lock community as a whole, but before I get into that, let me just say this last thing, and that's gonna lead into my lock community spiel. This week, hopefully, I plan on collabing with another fellow locker here on YouTube. Her name is Robin. I'm gonna put her name right here in the video. However, her name will be in the description box along with other lockers that I follow. The plan is to go with the flow. Definitely gonna be talking about our hair. So before I leave this week, I'm trying to link up with her. So now that I talked about that, I'm moving to the log community part of this. When I started making these log journey videos, I didn't expect to meet so many souls. I mean, this log community, it's no joke. We support each other and we follow each other. And it's crazy because we low-key know each other, but we don't know each other, and it's really exciting. I'll be on some other YouTuber channel who I follow who is on a log journey, and I'll see some of you guys comment on their videos, and I'm like, oh my god, like, we're watching the same person. Like, it's so cool to see that, and it's an extremely good feeling to know that everyone is kind of connected and intertwined in this web, and I love it. I want to give a shout out to one of my watchers. His name is Lock G. Gonna put his name right here. You guys need to subscribe and follow. I'm not gonna lie, he is actually the reason why I'm bringing this up. He DM'd me on Instagram and asked me to give him a shout out because he wants to, you know, do giveaways and he wants to do Q&As and he wants to play games, but he doesn't have any subscribers. So I want you guys to subscribe to him, and I want you to subscribe to everyone else that I'm gonna put in the description, because I think it's important. I think it's important to follow other people because everyone's journey is different. No one's hair is the same. You know, you might can relate to them and what they're going through more than you might relate to me. Because I'm not gonna lie, there has been some questions that I've been asked in the comments, and then, you know, I'll reply back to you guys and I'll be like, oh no, nah, like, I'm not going through that. I think it's just really cool to get to know people, period. And I know people may have expectations for videos, certain qualities that they look at in a video to watch it. You know, I understand that. It takes me a minute to click on a video. I can put something in the search box, but it won't end there. You know, first of all, your title has to grab me. Your thumbnail, the little clickbait, that needs to look appealing. And then I look at the name. I gotta look at how many views you think your video getting. Like, I look at all these things before I actually click on the video. And I learned that I can't do that. Sometimes it's beneficial, and then other times it's just like, what the hell are you talking about? Imagine if I would have never gotten to know these people because I didn't click on their video. Looks can be deceiving. You know, you really can't judge a book by its cover. I know some clickbait may look better than some other videos, but that doesn't necessarily mean that that person has more to offer. Definitely doesn't mean that the video will feed you answers that you're looking for. Some people don't have the environment to record the way they want to. They may not have the equipment, the right lighting, the camera quality, you know, but they still put the effort to make videos out there for us, the people. Like, they care enough to still put stuff out there, and that's enough for me. You know, trying is all I can ask for, so I would greatly appreciate it, and I know that the other lockers would greatly appreciate if you took the time out to check out their channel. To close out with this update, I do want to talk about reactions. I know, like, for the past couple of months, I've been saying that I've had no reactions and that it's just been compliments. And that has been true, but I am home. And you know what that means? Family. My hair is still strongly and extremely disliked by my mother. But, you know, I get the occasional comment every here and there. Ugh, you know, it's never too late to take that out. Ugh, look at your hair. Ugh, you know, a nice afro would really do you justice. Like, I'm gonna keep it 100. Most of my negative comments about my hair comes from the older generation. I don't get any negative comments from my peers. But what I really want to get at, and what I really want to close out at, is the older generation, when they tell me these negative comments and they make some type of opinion towards my hair, they never really address my hair itself. They always address things that I can't do because I have the hairstyle. I don't know how many times people keep telling me that I'm not going to get hired with my hair like this, or I'm not going to get a job, internship, wherever the hell I'm trying to go. I don't know how many times I've heard that. On top of that, all the people telling me that I'm not going to get a job are black people. And then I sit back and wonder, and it makes me think, why is it black people telling me that I'm not going to get a job with my hair like this? In my most natural state. If anything, I feel like we need to be encouraging each other, proud that someone is wearing their hair in their natural state, that they don't want to put these Eurocentric beauty standards up in their hair with all these perms and weaves and stuff if you really want to get technical with it. You know, I could care less about what they're saying, you know, because I don't give a fuck. I know thyself so well to the point where somebody can tell me something is wrong or bad for me, but if I'm happy and if I believe in my heart and soul that it's good, then, you know, nothing can really stop me, you know? And I don't really see the harm of having locks or even having a hairstyle like this, period. So it's not really the comments that really get to me. It's the fact that another sister or brother is saying this to me, putting me down instead of encouraging. A lot of them like to say that, you know, they're helping me or that they are just trying to tell me, you know, warn me ahead of time and stuff. But I believe that the tongue is a very powerful instrument. You can literally make yourself sick and destroy yourself. I just think that if I really did listen to these comments about me not getting a job and saying it looks ugly and all this stuff, like if I really listened to that, one, I wouldn't have my hair locked. Two, I'd be unhappy with myself because I don't have my hair locked. And three, I'd be just mad at the world. I'd be walking around here feeling like something's missing. I'm not saying that a job is not important. I'm not saying that money isn't important, but when it all boils down to it, when it all gets down to the real shit, it does not matter. I don't need those things to make me happy. And like I always tell people, if someone is not going to hire me because of my hair, I do not want to work for them anyway. I promise you, I will find someone who will hire me with my hair like this. It might take a couple of trial and errors, a couple of doors slammed in my face, a couple of no's, but that's okay. Like, that's life. I could go on about this all day, but this is not a ranting video. This is a lock update video. And that's why I say the lock community is so important. And I guess at the end of the day, what I'm trying to say is that if it wasn't for the lock community, if it wasn't for discovering that there are other people out there like me who have family members similar to mine. I said this in my very, very first video, in the introduction video, that I just want people to know that they're not alone. But from doing this, it really has helped me, and it lets me know that I'm not alone. So that's that. I'm sorry I'm ranting. I feel like because I'm ranting, this video is gonna be kind of long, but you know, definitely be here before next month to, like I said, give you guys the hairstyles. Make sure you hit that little subscribe button, you know, if you wanna. Make sure you follow me on all social media. Yes, that's at Pretty Ass Bree Triple. Thank you guys for coming back and starting this new year with me. If you actually came back, if you're just now joining us, welcome. We welcome you here. I hope all is well in your life. Peace, much love, thanks, and